The massage was called cancer and our safety shop and people, the site is obvious to all these people, and I'm humbled to be able to be here with you all tonight. Indigenous people are the past, the present, and the future of this land. Our first artist who's giving a talk, she's in the staff space. Her name is Summer Brooks. Summer Brooks is a multimedia sculpture artist currently based in Kansas City, Missouri. She earned a Bachelor's of Arts in McKendree University in 2021. She has received NCGIS Multicultural Fellowship Award in 2021 and exhibited work in the Multicultural Fellowship Exhibition in 2022. In 2021, she completed an exhibition at the Contemporary Art Museum in St. Louis, the New Garden Variety. Her work has been shown internationally at the CICA Museum in the exhibition Youth Number 8. Brooks also has shown work in the Undergraduate Exhibition 2021 at the Albert Camper Museum. Brooks was awarded the Foundation's residency at Belgrade Premier Art Studios and is currently a resident. Without further ado, I give you Summer Brooks. Thank you.
Thank you.
So I'm going to kind of speak on some of my experiences that I had as a Black woman growing up with my hair, and how that has really shaped my work. I feel like when I was growing up, I didn't have that support in that, you know, community to really embrace what, you know, beauty was. You know, of course my mom always told me I was beautiful. Of course, you know, my family was always like, you're so beautiful. And I got that from them. But when it came to like the greater society, you know, there was never an acceptance, really, of, like, Black hair. I had to navigate that space myself. I had to, you know, figure out what it means to have natural hair, to go through these feelings of, like, I hate my hair one day, and I love it the next day. And that also extended to, like, my skin tone and the, you know, like, is it too dark? Are my features too... my nose bridge to why, all these things that I had to think about. And when I really look at where the root of this is, it comes from when my ancestors stepped off the boat and they came to the United States against their will. And we had our head shaved. Black women were stripped of their femininity, and our hair products were taken from us, and this is like, it goes way, way back. You know, all this rhetoric of, you know, anti-Black and anti, you know, embracing yourself comes from this like Western ideal of beauty and stripping that from us and constantly telling us that we're never gonna be beautiful. And these are the things that I think about when I make my work, and it's incredibly painful. And, you know, when you look at these bright colors, you know, see that necessarily, and that's because I am trying to move away really from that connection, that stripping of hair, you know, that violent history that America has, and try to move towards a more, you know, embracing, bright future where I'm not necessarily thinking about so much like that type of stuff, that violent things that happen, but instead I'm thinking about like being in my mom's lap on Sunday and having her wash my hair and take care of me and put lotion on me and make sure that my hair looked good for school, regardless of if I had a relaxer or if I had box braids, whatever. She always made sure I was taken care of. And so I am kind of giving that to my pieces. I want them to be taken care of. I want them to have that nourishment that my mom gave me so that I can make this work. I can stand here and say that, you know, these things have affected me throughout my entire life, but I'm not gonna let that hold me down. So I want you to look at my work and see the nostalgia of, you know, these butterfly clips. You know, who wore the butterfly clips back to the breath, you know? Like, they were so vibrant and beautiful in our hair when we were kids. And like, we really need to bring that back, you know? That playful spirit we really had with, you know, playing around with our hair and things and our clothes and experimenting with makeup as a kid. And that's what I'm really trying to capture with my work. And I guess I can talk a little bit about what I do. So I kind of did like spray foam, and I talked a little bit about the butterfly clips, but spray foam is a really unpredictable medium, and I really enjoy working working with that because I can just kind of do what my hair does to me, like be unpredictable, you know? And so I'm using wax to add color into there, using gold to embellish these figures and make sure that, you know, that they are represented as royal figures, using purple to also kind of carry that semblance of royalty as well. And also making sure that not only butterfly clips, but I'm using beads and breasts and those hair clips that you see. And here, those, I wore those all the time. I had like a bucket full of them when I was a kid. And these little crowns, they're also hair products that I use in my own braids and things. So I'm trying to connect my materials with what makes me happy.